Welcome back, Dark Souls fans, to Let's Die Horribly in Dark Souls 3. I remain your host, ChataFury333, and I finally figured out where to go. I actually went to my last resort of basically assisting people, being summoned, and I found out where I'm actually supposed to go, although I need to do a couple things to make it a little bit safer, but I will finally make real progress. We need to kill this for one thing. There's a couple other enemies I need to kill, because if they are not dead, then I have to deal with them, or they're for- oh, shoot. This is actually the exact wrong way to do this. I've just committed suicide. Alright, let's try not to die. Ah. Can't say I feel like I'm doing a very good job here. Ah. Darn it, stupid wall. Okay, whatever, one down. Oh yeah, I also upgraded Faith a bit and got great heal, so now I have better heal. Although I can only cast two. And you're dead because you tried to spellcast right next to me and that was really bad spacing. Bad form. Okay, so. That's not the place. Across there, across the way in that little area there, that little plaza right on the other side, that's the place. But I need to wait until the Fire Witch and other Pontiff Knight go past there so I can get past them and then get in there relatively safely. That's the idea. At least that's the hope. Or not. I don't know. Seriously, there's two Pontiff Knights that are coming up and I don't want that. Okay, they're all going away. I actually have a chance. Sometimes I wonder if those spirit Pontiff Knights are actually there, or if they're just representations for my own benefit. I wonder sometimes. I mean, I feel like it's probably that they're there. Anyway, so that they're just representations. This, as far as I can tell, is the way to go. It sounds kind of weird because it's a secret. Oh, there's a Pontiff Knight. Well, whatever. Was a Pontiff Knight, because that's how I roll. Except in that case, I did not. There, for completeness' sake. But yeah, so this is where I was supposed to go, at least for one spot. I don't know if this is the entire solution, because I believe this is just the shortcut down to the starting area. I mean, it is clearly that shortcut, but there's also a ladder. Or, no, there's no ladder. This may actually be worse than I expected. No, that can't be, because why would there be a shortcut here? Right, boom, shortcut. Okay, so now what? Witch tree branch? Oh, I gotta look that up. Ow. Wait, this is fire hug. Dory's gnawing. Well, aren't you sad? Oh, wow, they actually got through. Once. Briefly, got through. Too bad for them. Alright, so, we have some story time. First off, we'll do that one spell that I just got, because Miracle of Dory's the Deranged Evangelist. Summons great insect swarm to feast on foes. Those who linger too long on the brink of the deep will often slip. Dory's is sure to have wallowed in this darkness, intoxicated by its peril. Alright, what else do I have? I didn't get any other spells. I did some minor exploration. I actually killed the enemy crabs in the, what was it called? The Road of Sacrifices. I got a ring for that, just a pyromancy ring. So if anyone's looking for pyromancy rings, killing one of those crabs, that works. And yes, I did find the weak point. It's the mouth. You beat it down a bit, and then you stab the mouth for massive damage. It worked pretty well. Where is it? The Swamp Ring. Great Swamp Ring, yeah. Rings tend to be chiseled from the bone of a flame salamander by blighted pyromancers living in the Great Swamp. Boost pyromancies. It is believed that salamanders are the descendants of demons born of the Chaos Flame, from which pyromancy is also said to have originated. I don't think I've picked up any other rings that I haven't shown you guys. And otherwise... Oh yeah, there was some armor I found too that was interesting. Some of it was relatively irrelevant. Which one was it? Oh yeah, the regular sorcerer trousers. A sorcerer knows that long-term research means a lengthy and arduous road abroad. That's, yeah, not much. And I think that was it. Yeah. This is, oh, northern actually. Trousers of a stalwart northern warrior, thick leather boots lined with fur. In addition to their protection from blunt strikes, they excel at retaining heat, providing good resistance to the cold. I mean, the drank stuff I already showed. I guess northern's also similar. So yeah, northern's kind of leather thing. Oh, and I found this too. Shield of the Pontiff Knights, frigid spirits that linger in Irithyll. This blue-gray shield, shrouded in a thinly cold air, is light and brittle. And I also didn't pick up any charms. Oh, witch tree branch. Branch of a large, well-tended witch tree used as a sorcery catalyst. Witch tree staves are customary in the far north and allow for faster casting than ordinary catalysts. I think I already have one of these. I might have already shown one of them. Oh, I see. Yeah. I've already done that. I think that's everything. I don't think I really missed anything else. So, yeah. We're all caught up. This shortcut can't just be useless. There's something I'm missing. Secret or something. I mean, it's clear at this point that the Irithyll the Boreal Valley has got some secrets or something. Because I had to get through a secret to get here in the first place. I had to attack something. And also, this is a shortcut. Why would it be a shortcut to this? Unless I was silly and missed a shortcut that was up here. Like, in my excitement to get down here, I missed a shortcut, like a ladder or something I could kick down in order to get down here faster, or get up from here. But I don't see anything, so whatever it is not obvious. And also a pain in the butt to get to, as evidenced by the fact that I had to sneak around to get here in the first place. But I don't really see anything else. This is weird. I'm finding this very annoying. This place is really pissing me off now because I cannot find the way to go. I feel like I've looked everywhere. And it's like, okay, yeah, I got a shortcut that does me no good. Like this random evangelist. Oh yeah, that reminds me. That was another thing I found actually. Was the armor for those guys. Or not guys, actually. They're women. Was evangelist robe. Robe of an evangelist sent from the cathedral. These teachers, all women, came to enlighten inhabitants of the undead settlement and sent carriers on the path to sacrifice. Okay, so that's that. Unless it's like Frozen to Lamb Lois, where you have to pick up some special thing that gives you vision of invisible things. Oh, well, whatever. Once I get a hit on them, they're dead. Assuming I can kick properly, which I never can. Oh, death crossbow bolt. That's always nice. Alright, so, there's a bunch of smaller enemies here. So now I just gotta wonder, am I missing something that I've... Because, I mean, clearly I just found a shortcut through a secret. Which means, evidently, there's probably shortcuts through other secrets, if not the main path to go. Oh yeah, you guys are trivial, as long as I get the drop on you, and I have, so... There we go, you're done. Well, this doesn't look like it would likely provide a place to go. I mean, the place where I found the secret just there, that had some obvious... It was pretty obvious that there was something. just because, I mean, you're dealing with... Ow. I was just saying, you're dealing with a shortcut that you already know about at the start. Ow. Alright. Alright. I'll live with that. For now. I'll live. It's the important thing. Okay, so... What else do I have to deal with? Oh yeah, right. That Fire Witch, those two Pontiff Knights. But I don't really care about that right now. What I care about is that I'm now trying to figure out where that other secret is. Because there's got to be one. There's just got to be something around here. I have failed to attack. I mean, granted, that one had a note that said try attacking. I haven't seen that anywhere else. But, yeah, I mean, now I know where I'm supposed to go with it. Hmm. Oops. Ha, got his attention. That's actually a really hard shot. Come on, come at me. Aw, seriously? Is it not gonna come at me? No, should probably just wait for the three smaller zombies. I'm sorry, this is gonna take a little while. Okay, good, got one of their attentions. That is not a plural word, or a word you can pluralize properly like that. I got the attention of one of them. Would be the correct way of pluralizing that, or phrasing that in the first place. Okay, shoot. I'm gonna have to deal with this. Ah, right, that Holmes. Shoot. I don't wanna go and have to deal with the other Pontiff Knights there, because they're not gonna be fun. I'm gonna probably have to anyway. Shoot! Well, if I only have to deal with one of them, that's fine. Get over here! Alone, preferably. One of you, I don't really care which. Get over here, do something stupid, let me kill you. There we go. Wow, that was actually not what I expected as the result, but it worked out better than I thought it would. Ow. There we go. That's what I wanted. Okay, good. Now just the Fire Witch, and then I think I've actually cleared the top of this. Oh, okay, it's gonna be idle. Good. That makes my life easier. Is there nowhere I can try attacking here? Seriously, is there nothing? There has got to be another secret I'm missing. I can start selling those immolation tenders. I have three of them so far, and at least three of them. I'm not even sure how many I have, honestly. Oh, shoot. Okay, good. The Pontiff Knights is coming along. Oh, yes! The backstab! Awesome! I love getting backstabs. Into a meaty strong attack. That went brilliantly. Is that it? Oh, I thought I rolled. Okay. I'm noticing that compared to several episodes ago, I'm still having troubles rolling accurately or having the roll actually work all the time when I expect it to. But I do have enough health that I can survive when it screws up or when everything goes wrong. Like, just that seems to be the only difference. So I'm not sure if rolling is happening any more often or any more accurately or any more when I want it to than it did before. So I'm still bugged by that. Like, it's not a bug, it's just I'm annoyed because that I don't agree with the design decision. But I said my piece about that in episode 32, so if you wanted, like, go to the halfway mark of episode 32 when I'm fighting the old Demon King, you could just see my entire spiel about that. Or, if you don't want to watch, basically, I think when they changed Dark Souls 2 to have the L3 be jump, they should have changed that to be run and kept the B button or the circle button as jump, as well as keep it also for backstep and roll, and then when you press it, any of those actions happen depending on your movement speed, rather than being something you have to release for it to happen. But whatever. What? No! Shoot. Okay, well, at least I didn't die or lose anything, and also didn't really show that anything was wrong here. Okay, what am I supposed to do? So I've managed to clear out Irithyll. I've actually managed to clear out Irithyll, this place that was causing me so many problems, and felt like I had to sneak around, and I still kind of did. I've managed to clear it out, clear all the enemies at the top deck of Irithyll, on the ground level. Now what? I have no idea. I mean, I guess a lot of people aren't going to really call for assistance unless they have someone who's already gotten, say, to the boss, or they've already gotten, say, the boss fight, which I'm nowhere near any boss fight because I can't find where to go. Oh, what's this? Lizard ahead. What? Maybe it's in that area there. I don't see any lizards. But yeah, Irithyll has been the land of illusions, so I would not be surprised if there were some more illusions that I'm dealing with that I basically have to figure out where they are, or what's going on, or how to open things, or what to smack in order to reveal paths, because at this point, I can't find anything. And this doesn't open from this side. I figured there'd be a try attacking somewhere. Well, I'll cut to when I find something. Assuming I find something. Welcome back, Dark Souls fans. I am blind! So, from what I can tell, the way to go that I missed was there's the Distant Manor. So that's the path to the Irithyll Dungeon and all the stuff that I did before with Yorm. I went down here, just sort of walking down, saw that, followed that. Did not look immediately to my left at the sewer system over here, or the aqueduct, whatever it is. Actually, it's on the ground, so it's more of a sewer. Anyway, I did not see this. That was a mistake, because this is most likely where to go. Also, I ended up, in my attempt to get to help others to help myself, I ended up helping someone beat the boss of the area, so I know what the boss of the area is. So I'm slightly spoiled, not as blind as I would otherwise be. But yeah, I feel really foolish now because I didn't look to the left. I mean, it's a good thing. I basically was just going through the area everywhere. That's actually the reason for the torch is that I thought, oh, maybe this works in this weird way where I have to have a torch. Now that sounds weird, but I thought maybe it was kind of like the way that Ulysseal worked, where in Ulysseal, in Dark Souls 1, if you had a torch, there were certain areas that you could see, or some sort of light. It doesn't have to be a torch. It could have been, actually, torches didn't exist in that game. It was Skull Lantern, the Cast Light Spell, or a Sunlight Maggot, the headgear. Those were your options for creating light, and you needed that in order to find the secret areas of Ulysseal. It was a very unique mechanic to that particular area, and come to think of it, is unique as far as all three games go, I believe. But I thought, oh, maybe they were reusing that. That's what I thought. And I was wrong. The truth is, I just can't see a sewer system when it's right to my left. So if those wondering how to outsmart me when it comes to sewers, place them directly to my left and I shall miss them fully. Because apparently, That is what I do. Because, yeah, now we have another path. And I... Do I hear bonfire? Nope. I hear an Estus pot. That's Estus soup. Which I don't think replenishes my Estus flasks. It just replenishes my health, as far as I know. Could be wrong. Don't really feel like testing it. That is a one-shot item. And... Yeah. So my only concern now is, of course, Pontiff Knights. Although, admittedly, if those come up, I can deal with them. And I have 6 Estus swigs left. Did these hide anything? No. But hey! New stuff! And you guys didn't have to spend the 20-ish minutes or so that I spent finding what the heck was going on. Alright, so... There's a Black Knight. And apparently a sniper of sorts. And a pretty reflective floor. Aha. Headshot. Aw, seriously, I gotta go for body shots, I guess. Ow. Friend hasn't woken up yet. Ah. How much does Great Heal heal me anyway? I haven't actually tested how far this goes. Oh wow, quite a ways. Oops. All right. Oops. Oh, I hit it too. This is annoying. I need to S this up. I have 2 giant arrows sticking out of me. Oh, 3 giant arrows sticking out of me. I can't imagine how you deal with this pure melee. I mean, obviously that's gonna hit you on the other side, so... Like, if you're attacking the Black Knight and trying to get through there... That's obviously gonna hurt you. But, whatever, that's not my concern because I'm not playing pure melee. Alright, sniper down. At greater cost than I'd hope for- ooh! And I get 2 large Titanite shards, which are not totally useless, but are mostly useless. I think right now I have everything plus 7. Oh no, Saint's Talisman, actually. I do have use. How many do I have then? Enough! Okay, cool. I have 6, which is exactly how many I need. Aww. The Black Knight is mourning Guinevere. Or I guess the illusion of Guinevere. Hang on. Huh. No, this looks vaguely familiar, but it's not really what I'm thinking of. Actually, that looks like Nishandra from Dark Souls 2. That looks a lot... Yeah, well, no cursing, but yeah, that does look like her. Kind of. That is Guinevere, though. That is Guinevere from Dark Souls 1. And better covered, from the looks of it. Yep. Ooh. Yes, I know. We all miss Guinevere. Except for me, because she was an illusion, so I actually don't miss anything, because there's nothing there to miss! Spoilers, sorry. If you haven't played Dark Souls 1, that's spoilers. A lie. Ah, there we go! Oh, can I put it down? I gotta put it down. This hasn't been necessary until just now. I don't even know if I can do this, because I think... No, it needs to be, or, actually, no, I'm looking for amazing, because Dark Souls 1, that was what you put in front of Guinevere, was amazing chest ahead, but it looks like they Don't allow you to do that. I'm disappointed. There's apparently, as far as I can tell, no amazing modifier. Of course, I could always put gorgeous view ahead, but that's a little bit too... Nope, nothing here. All right, never mind. Amazing chest ahead used to be a thing you could do. And it was just, it was a, such, it was a meme, honestly. It was such a meme, but yeah. That was the Dark Souls 1 thing. And hey, we're in the lower Irithyll streets. I'm glad of this. Yeah, I guess if you're a melee, you just lure the Black Knight into this area over here, these alcoves, and then you just deal with it over here and dispatch it here. Okay, I guess I do need to have the torch, because I do not have any way of easily seeing. This is darker than I expected. And apparently oh, I see. That's the revenge. Oh. Well, would be the revenge. Alright. Oh, seriously, I missed? There we go. Whoa! Ow. Ah! Alright. I'm good. Hey! I killed it! I actually survived! Wanted to get my FP back by stabbing it rightly, but... that didn't work. Oh, well. I have no more Ashen Estus. I'm low on regular Estus. I've got a new path for which I'm excited, and I'm... which one of these are mimics? Not a mimic. Oh, none of these are mimics, really? Double check. Nope, none of these are mimics. You can tell by the chain. The chain is the reason... oh, Leo Ring! Nice! I'll have some stuff to talk about in a moment. But yeah, these chains, if they curve around, like this curve here, it's if they curve around the other way. If they curve towards the front of the chest, then you know it's a mimic. Also, I've noticed mimics tend to be lighter colored. Smough's Great Hammer, and... oh! Is that what this area is supposed to be? Is this supposed to be... well, it's not really a recreation of, but the Ornstein and Smough boss fight from Dark Souls 1 looks like it. So let's go over what I just got. Leo Ring... but strengthens thrust counterattacks, because Leo Ring was all about using spears. And what is the description? Ring associated with the Dragon's Lair Ornstein, one of the four knights of Gwyn, the First Lord. Strengthens thrust weapon counterattacks. Ornstein was the first knight of the Sun's Eldest Born, and his cross spear is said to have pierced scales made of stone. He was also known as an accomplished jazz musician, although, admittedly, the Dark Souls universe didn't quite appreciate those particular talents, and quite frankly, it was ahead of his time. Still, made a good living killing dragons. So that's something. And Smough's Great Hammer. Twisted Great Hammer associated with Smough, the last knight to remain at his post, guarding the ruined cathedral. Restore HP while attacking, a carryover from Smough's past as an executioner. And it's a poise boost. Skill, perseverance. And then Divine Blessing, because Guinevere was a goddess after all. So, yeah, that's a thing. Oh. Pots with Frostbite in them. You know, I just remembered, I haven't actually had to deal with Frostbite all that much in Irithyll, surprisingly enough. Despite it being the Boreal Valley, I've barely had to deal with Frostbite. Alright, there's a threat around here somewhere. There's gotta be a threat around here somewhere. Okay, why not even try that? I know where that leads. That's the room I was just in. Admittedly, it would be nice to have a shortcut. even an illusory one. But I don't think that's to be. And no, that's not to be. Okay, I think I'm... I kind of want to get to a bonfire and then end the episode. Wow, my durability, my weapon durability is actually noticeably low. Yeah, it's 30 out of 70. That hasn't happened where I've noticed the durability drop. Now, part of that is I've been smacking this sword into walls for the last 20 minutes. That was off camera. I've cut that out. Don't worry about it. But, like, I didn't find anything, so yeah. Okay. What do we have here? Large Soul of Nameless. Oh. Take cover, or not. Oh! That worked beautifully. I'm not gonna credit myself for any of that, but that worked beautifully. But yeah, weapon durability is kind of low just because I have, like I said... Oh! Ash Nessus is back! Crap! I kind of wasted that. I could have healed. I could have used Great Heal, but whatever. I'll live. Okay, one of you is down. Hey, it's an elevator! Oh! Nice, this is a shortcut. Elevators are usually shortcuts. But I do want to get rid of this Joker first, because I'd like to get rid of that guy first. Hey, I got more regular Estus. Try mount. Is that a horse? No, it's a large titanite shard. And this, be wary of bright spot. Be wary of light map issues. All right, well, let's open the shortcut. Hooray! We made progress! Alright, so I'm gonna end the episode after I open the door. So we are back here, and the physics is caught up. Alright, so that is gonna be it for this episode. Thanks for watching, and stay tuned for the next one.